We are reading this evening from Bhagavad Gita as it is, chapter 18, entitled The Perfection of Renunciation, text number 2. Shri Bhagavan Uvacha Kamyanam Karmanam Nyasam Sanyasam Kavayo Viduhu Sarva Karma Falatyagam Prahustyagam Vichakshanah. Translation and purport by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai. The Supreme Personality of Godhead said, the giving up of activities that are based on material desire is what great learned men call the renounced order of life, sannyas. And giving up the results of all activities is what the wise call renunciation, tyag. Purport. The performance of activities for results has to be given up. This is the instruction of Bhagavad Gita. But activities leading to advanced spiritual knowledge are not to be given up. This will be made clear in the next verses. In the Vedic literature, there are many prescriptions of methods for performing sacrifice for some particular purpose. There are certain sacrifices to perform to attain a good son or to attain elevation to the higher planets, but sacrifices prompted by desires should be stopped. However, sacrifice for the purification of one's heart or for advancement in spiritual science should not be given up. Renunciation, this word is very much dreaded by people. Like herein, the word is used sannyas. And especially at this age, these words, forget about in a daily conversation, even if somebody mistakenly questions or inquires about sannyas or renunciation, tyag, virakti, is considered to be a weirdo, considered to be a crazy person. Now we see that one of the six opulences of Lord Sri Krishna is renunciation, vairagya. It's renunciation. So how come renunciation become an opulence? Generally, our definition of opulence is when you have everything. When you, isko kehte na aishwarya shali. When you have good looks, when you have wealth, strength, power, you know, charisma, popularity, fame, recognition, that's called opulence. And renunciation of all of that, how can that become an opulence? I remember when I was in the Air Force, so they used to have these parties. You know, defense people, they are very much into parties. And in all these parties, people would drink. And I remember one particular unit I was posted, I was the only one who was the teetotaler, would not drink. And I was the odd man out, obviously. If everyone else is drinking and you don't drink, then you are the odd man out. Just like over here, you have come for a spiritual program. Over here, if somebody starts smoking, that person becomes odd man. But imagine where everyone else is doing that and you are not doing, you become the odd man. So again, everything is very relative in this world. So, I remember one of commanding officers, he saw me just with a glass of lemon juice, nimbu pani. And he came to me, everyone else was having, you know, like the black label, old monk, officer's choice, like that. And here, what? Nimbu Pani? Seriously? So he inquired that, why? Is it because, you have some cultural, traditional vows which you have taken, something religious? At that time I was not in touch with Krishna consciousness. But I had my own ideologies and philosophy of life. So I told him that I don't want a bottle of whiskey to decide my happiness, or a bottle of liquor or a glass of liquor to decide whether I should be happy or not. You may call it ego, or you may call it renunciation. What are we discussing? Renunciation. Now you see, we'll discuss about the four regulative principles which Prabhupada gave. No intoxication, no meat eating, no gambling, no illicit sex. The four regulative principles. Now in this verse which we just took, Krishna explains about when there is attachment which leads to one's degradation, that has to be renounced. The mentality of being attached, that has to be renounced. So Srila Prabhupada's spiritual master, he would narrate a story, very interesting story. There was a marriage party and they had to go to the other village, the boy's side, the groom's side. They had to go on the other side of the village, to the other village, crossing a river. Barat jani thi. Like that, the marriage party had to go. So they fixed a boat and a boatman, and the entire family along with all the marriage paraphernalia, they were all set with high spirits. Tomorrow is a big day for the family. The groom is getting married. So it was, they had proposed in this way that in the evening they will board the boat, and the whole night it will take for the boatman to take them across. And the next day morning they will be there ready to dive into the ceremony. So that was the plan. And the boatman assured, yes, you just relax, you can have a nice peaceful sleep as the rocking effect of the boat will give you a better sleep, sound sleep. So rest assured that next day morning you will be at your destination. So they all boarded the boat. They settled themselves for a while. They were looking at, the ripples and the waves and the soothing atmosphere. And it was getting pitch dark. As it was getting darker and darker, the night pouring in. And they went off to sleep. And our boatman, he was rowing. He was rowing, and you know how rowing is done. It takes a lot of effort. People, they do rowing for exercise also. So he was rowing and he was sweating, and whole night he was doing that. And guess what? Next morning, as the sun rose and everyone rose within the boat, what do they see? They're exactly at the same spot. The boat didn't even move an inch. They looked at the boatman. What happened? And the boatman, he said, I don't know. Whole night, just look at me, I am sweating whole night. Not even a minute that I stopped rowing. Whole night I was rowing. Then why didn't the boat move forward? So Saraswati Thakur, he then reveals the suspense. Why the boat didn't move when everything was in place according to the boatman. He had forgotten to remove the anchor. Now this appears to be something very ordinary and simple. Forgot to remove the anchor. Just like, you know, so he, as a matter of fact, said, oh, I just forgot to remove the anchor. Whenever you add this word just, everything appears to be very simple and ordinary. Oh, he is just a student. He is just a businessman, which means nothing else other than that. So he said, as a matter of fact, I just forgot to remove the anchor. Now you see, certain things in our life, they may appear to be very small in nature. But that doesn't mean that anything which is small in nature is unimportant. What is the modern man's psychology generally? That anything which is big, which is complex, has to be important. And therefore when they come for the Hare Krishna talks and we say just chant Hare Krishna, we also use the word just chant Hare Krishna. And then somebody asks that, so how was the talk, pravachan means it has to be complicated, you know. In your engineering lecture, it has to be complicated, otherwise how can it be engineering? The more complicated, the fatter the book, it appears to be something tangible. Like I saw there was a book, it was just like we have this Bhagavad Gita here. For some people this Bhagavad Gita appears to be so fat and so big. Itni badi book. So I saw it was double the size. And the title of that book was How to Use a Comma. Imagine. How to Use a Comma. I was thinking, before someone understands and reads the entire book, his life will have a full stop. How to use a comma. So, anything which is simple doesn't necessarily has to be unimportant. For example, have you all used ink pen? Yes. Now imagine an ink pen and you like to put it on your pocket here, you know. Appears to be like you are educated when there is a pen here. So you're going to your college with a very nice, you know, white shirt. But the ink pen doesn't have a cap on it. Appears to be something, a simple thing, which is unavailable. Ink pen not having a cap on it appears to be just a minor detail. But that minor detail not present on the pen, what will happen? We know what happens. Like, you know, on my way back from Bombay, I went to Pune, from Pune came over here. So there was one devotee who got a water bottle for me, you know, that on the way if you get thirsty. So I had to put it in my bag. It so happened that when that water bottle, you know, I was using it, and then somehow the cap, I lost it somewhere. Yes? Dakkan. Lost the cap. Now that cap is such small thing, but I couldn't use the water bottle, couldn't put that water bottle in my bag because of the missing cap. Something so small, yet so important. That's the point. So in Krishna consciousness also, you will find there will be things which will appear to be very simple and very small in nature, but yet they might have the profundity and the importance which we cannot even fathom. Just like, even if negatively you see, one virus enters into someone's body, sometimes it's not even detected. Like HIV, it has an incubation period. Sometimes a decade goes by and the patient is having the virus within, it's not even detected. And after 10 years or sometimes 20 years, the effect and the symptoms of that disease manifest. Like in your computer, a virus enters. You can't even detect where is it. It's called virus. But can you locate with your naked eye? Dikh raha hai, ghus raha hai, yahan se ghus raha, virus ghus raha. From where it entered. So something very small, it enters like a Trojan horse and takes over the entire kingdom of your life. A mosquito. Sometimes you don't even realize when the mosquito bit you, where it bit you, how long was it sitting on your body, where. But then when you are hospitalized, malaria, obviously malaria is because of mosquito biting. So you can't, even if you have all the CCTV and everything on, that kab aaya mosquito, kahan se, kaun si khidki se aaya, kahan baitha, idhar baitha, yahan baitha, kidhar kaata usne, kaise kaata, kitni der tak baitha tha. Aur kai baar bahut sare baithe honge, in mein se kaun sa tha jisne mere ko malaria diya. Something so small and trivia, but then the effect of that is fatalistic many times. So herein, when in this particular story, the anchor example is used. So the anchor is compared to attachment. So yes, you come for the Thursday programs, you may be chanting also, and it's like rowing. Yes, you know, chanting also, like Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare. That motion is going on. But then you find, after few years, now to aage jai nahi rahi hai. Pasine pasine ho rahe hai, but I don't find. You see why people, they tend to not be so enthusiastic for any spiritual practice? Because the results are not seen so obviously. Therefore, we start doubting. Really? Is it really working? Does it really work? Because other things, we are so used to getting obvious results. You go to gym, and first day you lift and you know all the joints pain. Kuch karke aaya. You know, when you are really, first time you go to gym and enthusiastically you work out for 2 hours, and then you feel all the biceps and triceps tightened here, and then all, you know, the thighs and the calf muscles all tightened. Lag raha hai, bas, I am becoming Iron Man. And then next day morning when you go to use the toilet, you can't even sit. If you sit, you can't get up. That's the situation. And then you keep on working out in the gym, you get the results, you see. You're getting in shape. You know, all the packs are coming. 4, 6, 8, the packs are coming. Biceps all bulging out. You know, from A, it's becoming V. Pehle shape A tha. You go to gymnasium, you see the result. You go for swimming, yes. You learn swimming, you flap your hands and legs, you see you yourself going ahead. All these things, you will find the results immediately. But then, when you come for the program here, and then you are told, so chant Hare Krishna, what will happen? You will get concentration. You will develop your mental muscles. It's a mental gymnasium. The gymnasium of the mind. Enter into the gymnasium of the mind. What is this? This is a gymnasium for the mind. And right now, all of you are sitting. I'm sitting. While sitting, no sweating. But working out is going on. What is going on right now? The mind is getting its exercise. But then, you find that, you know, the attachments, those attachments are still there. Sometimes the attachments, they become even more intensified. Earlier, we never thought that the mind gets distracted also. Why? Because it was never at home. Therefore, we never realized, oh, mind is not with me right now. जैसे कोई बच्चा अगर हर समय लापता हो तो रूटीन बन जाता है, वो रहता ही नहीं घर पे. ज्यादा रहने लग जाए और फिर गायब हो जाए तो समझ में आता गायब है. सो व्हाट्स हैपनिंग व्हेन वी प्रैक्टिस सम स्पिरिचुअलिटी, वी ट्राई टू नो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल द माइंड इज सपोज टू बी विद इन अस, नॉट रोमिंग अराउंड लॉयटरिंग हियर एंड देयर. And then, when you try to bring the mind again and again, and the mind keeps running here and there, more rebellious in nature at that time. So then you find, oh, so this is something real workout of the mind going on. But then the attachment is such that spontaneously, what is unhealthy appears to be pleasurable. See the dichotomy of this world. Anything which is healthy many a times is not tasty. And anything which is tasty many a times is unhealthy. You agree? Like, you know, bhagar. Today is Ekadashi. So, bhagar is something which you won't order in a restaurant. Friends ko jaake, aaj chalo bhagar kha ke aate. Wo bhi kahan? Pizza hut mein jaate. Pizza hut mein jaake usko, bhagar hai bhagar. Yep. पिज्जा के ऊपर भगर का टॉपिंग लगाएंगे. नो, बट यू नो ऑल दीज थिंग्स दे अपीयर टू बी सो टेस्टी. ऑल द फैटी फूड्स अपीयर टू बी द टेस्टीएस्ट ऑफ ऑल फूड्स. सो यू सी अगेन अनदर डाइकोटोमी इन दिस वर्ल्ड. यू विल फाइंड दैट ऑन वन हैंड all the celebrities, they are all well in shape. All these Bollywood, Hollywood stars, you'll find, you know, proper shapely body. You won't find them, you know, with pot bellies, you know, the main hero of the movie, you know. He's having, you know, like a tond bahar aa raha hai uska. Many times because they work out so much, unko upar baniyan pehna padta hai, dikhane ke liye ki itna maine mehnat kiya hai, dekho kam se kam. To bichare ko shirt nikal ke gana gana padta hai. Hai na? Kyun itna mehnat kiya to dikhna chahiye na? To kya fayda? To director bolta hai shirt nikal do. तो हाँ फिर बाद में सब लोग देखते हैं गाना कौन सुनता है क्या बाइसेप्स है क्या ये और वो भी तेल वेल लगा के फिर कैमरा इधर इधर एंगल से ऐसे लगता है कि जैसे कि परफेक्ट ब्रह्मा जी ने इसको बनाया है ऑफ कोर्स सम ऑफ देम यू नो दे सो अननेचुरली ट्राई टू शेप अप देमसेल्व्स दैट You know, the side effects are so severe. Ritik Roshan, you know, he's considered to be the most, you know, charismatic of all heroes with that kind of a perfect shape. And his condition is that everything which appears to be on the screen is appearing to be in the most perfect physique. What a man can desire, the perfect physique. But his back is completely destroyed. That's not seen. And who wants to see? So life is like that. Jo dikhta hai samaj ko, usko ekdam intact rakho. Jo nahi dikhta hai, under the carpet, under the carpet. So this is called under the carpet civilization. Ghar mein guest aa rahe hain, गंदगी है कारपेट को उठाओ नीचे डालो कारपेट को उठाओ नीचे डालो बट फॉर हाउ लॉन्ग आफ्टर अ वाइल द कारपेट स्टार्ट स्टिंकिंग सो इट्स लाइक यू नो इन द वेस्टर्न वर्ल्ड ऑल्सो एंड नाउ कमिंग टू इंडिया ऑल्सो इट्स कॉल्ड यू डोंट हैव टू टेक बाथ एवरी डे जस्ट यूज डिओड्रेंट्स है ना डिओड्रेंट यूज करते रहो परफ्यूम्स यूज करते रहो वो लोग वही करते हैं सुबह उठा बस ब्रश किया समटाइम्स दे डोंट इवन हैव टाइम टू गो टू द लू इवन इफ दे गो एवरीथिंग इज कॉन्स्टिपेटेड सो यू नो द सिस्टम इज टोटली जैम्ड द सिस्टम से कांट डाउनलोड सो लाइक दैट यू नो Over there, because it's always cold weather, so who's going to take bath? Taking bath every day? Like, you know, one particular house I was staying and I was taking bath thrice a day, even in the winter season. And you know, the children of the house, they were like, really? Thrice a day? We take bath like thrice in a year. So cover up yourself with some deodorant and perfume. It's like under the carpet, under the carpet. So the point over here is that we are talking about attachments. Now attachments are such that they are generally not very much welcomed. All these words, you know. Discipline, self-control, mind control, renunciation, tyag, virakti. Oh my God. They are like we abhor all these words. Forget about the qualities which we have to apply in our life. The words itself are very much appalling for us. So what is this attachment? Asakti. किसको बोलते हैं वॉट इज इट एग्जैक्टली एनीथिंग विच मेक्स यू एडिक्टेड बिकॉज ऑफ विच यू फील दैट यू आर इनकम्प्लीट दैट बिकम्स योर अटैचमेंट नाउ यू विल फाइंड दैट अ फिश looks at a bait, you know, one who goes for fishing, he has the hook, and for the fish, some worm or some meat is stuck to the hook, and the fisherman is sitting with the fishing rod. Now he knows what's the weakness of the fish. तो वहां पर जाके वो एडवर्टाइज नहीं कर रहा है कि आओ आओ तुम्हारे लिए यहां पे खाने के लिए नया आइटम, नया रेस्टोरेंट खुला है यहां पे. जस्ट द फिश इज स्विमिंग अराउंड, दे हैव सो मच टू ईट विद इन द बॉडी ऑफ वॉटर, बट देन वेन दे सी ओ यूर लुक्स लाइक समथिंग न्यू एंड दे गो एंड दे आर हुक्ड एंड द फिशरमैन फिशेज द फिश आउट. And the fish is flapping. You find the mouse also trapped like that. How? There is a mouse trap. And there is a piece of cheese. And the mouse enters, trying to, first smells and enters into, trying to enjoy that piece of cheese. But then, he's become a cheese inside. The Hindi wala cheese. Inside the mouse trap. Now, will you call that as addiction? No. Why? Because the fish and the mouse didn't know that it's a trap. But you see a human being smoking. Now from nowhere, the cigarette looks like food. For a fish and for a mouse, from every angle, yes, it is food, but there is a trap behind. But for a smoker, from no angle, the cigarette stick looks like food. The smoker knows that this is poison. And even if, say, someone is so ignorant that doesn't even know what he's doing. So just to inform that smoker, the cigarette company prints the statutory warning. That in case if you didn't know what you're doing, what you're into, here is a statutory warning. What it does to you. And nowadays there are graphic pictures of, you know, charred lungs. You open the cigarette pack and this is what your lungs are going to become. Now enjoy. So imagine that if the fish and the mouse were informed, you are going to be killed if you go and enjoy that worm or that piece of meat on that hook, or you go to enjoy that cheese, you are going to be trapped forever. Do you think the mouse and the fish would, you know, after knowing, would risk their lives for that? But human beings, they know in and out of these addictions. And they can see the result. It's not that they have just heard or seen someone else, but they themselves. I'm not exaggerating. I saw this with my own eyes. From Delhi to Bombay, I was once on a train. And, you know, the train stopped. I think it was Valsad or Surat or some station like that. And I just looked out from the window and I was shocked and surprised and amazed to see a scene. There was like a beggar on the platform and he didn't have his arms from here. He only had shoulders. No arms. And he was smoking a bidi. Imagine how. So he had his right foot over the left knee. And the bidi was stuck in between the toe and the first finger. Aur wo pairon se bidi ko yahan pe laga laga ke pee raha tha. Now allow. Now somebody, you know, nowadays, that time there was no WhatsApp or these kind of camera phones. So people would, you know, make a video of that and circulate. This is called determination. Where there is a will, there is a way. Where there is a will, there is a BD. So, going to such extents, and people, those who are addicted, I'm just talking about here in just smoking or drinking, there are other kinds of addiction, you know. Those heavy drugs, when people go into those, you know, drugged life, totally stoned, they can sell everything of theirs and they are ready to kill anyone just to get that drug inside their system. That's called attachment. Like this example is given in Aniti Shastras, how a hunter catches a parrot. Very interestingly, because if you know these parrots who are sold in cages, if these parrots, they are shot by the hunter, a wounded parrot nobody is going to buy. People, they buy these parrots who are good looking and intact. So how the hunter catches a parrot who is alive and who is intact, who is not wounded. So very interestingly, it works with the parrot's psychology. On that tree where mostly the parrots, they perk and sit, what this hunter does is, he suspends a swing, jhula. So it's like a bamboo, hollow, and you know there is a rope going, a thick rope going, passing through the bamboo. But the bamboo is suspended to rotate. It's made like, you know, a swing for the parrot to come and sit on it. So when the parrot, by mistake or curious that what is this new thing on the branch, so goes and tries to sit on that swing, on that bamboo, so holds that bamboo with its claws. And because of the weight of the parrot, the bamboo rotates. So as the bamboo rotates, the parrot thinks that the parrot is about to fall down and holds it even more tighter. The tighter the parrot holds, the more the bamboo rotates. Now what the parrot, at that time the hunter who is hiding behind the bushes comes and very conveniently, without doing anything, as sees the parrot is busy trying to hold more tighter so that it shouldn't fall, the hunter takes the parrot, puts in the cage, end of parrot's freedom. What the parrot had to do? It had to just let go. It forgets that it can fly so high, it has wings. So that illusion which is created by the hunter for the parrot is called attachment. That when someone is addicted to something, so someone is addicted to smoking, after a while, it's not that that act of smoking is giving so much pleasure, but the refraining from that act of smoking appears to be so dreadful. How can I live without smoking? How can I live without drinking? How can I live without a girlfriend? So when people would ask, you don't smoke, you don't drink, you don't have a girlfriend, why do you live? One of my friends, you know, why do you live? So herein, when we are talking of attachment, which is like that anchor, which is anchoring and not allowing the boat to go further. So yes, release of that, all the other things you will find. So I told that we'll discuss about the four regulative principles also, which Prabhupada introduced. So when Arjun was told, proposed by Krishna to control the mind in the sixth chapter, Arjun, now imagine, who is Arjun in the Dwapar Yuga? This conversation is going on in Dwapar Yuga when Krishna says, Jitatmana Prashantasya Paramatma Samahita, that have control over your mind. And Arjun says, Chanchalam Himana Krishna Pramathi Balavadridham. You know, all the adjectives Arjun uses, that how it's impossible for him to control the mind. Now here is Arjun, who is from Dwapar Yuga, who is born in such a cultured family. Mother is Kunti. Brothers are Yudhishthir, Bhima and Nakul and Sahadev. Imagine the kind of satsang he was having every day. And that too now Krishna personally, as a sakha, for so many years, he is the chariot driver. And that Arjun, having that kind of association, is saying, my mind is impossible to control. What's our condition? That whom do we associate with? Whom do we hang out with? So, Krishna, he upon hearing that impossibility proposed by Arjun, Krishna in the next verse says, Asamshayam tu Mahabaho. Yes, without any doubt, whatever you are saying, Arjun, bina kisi sanshay ke, that's true. Yes, the mind is difficult, but it's not impossible. Man dur nigraha, Krishna is saying. Ye man jo hai, keval nigrah karne mein itna mushkil, dur nigraha hai ye man. Itna kathin hai isko niyantran mein lana. Now, who is saying this? Krishna. So, if you just read the first part of that verse, bina sanjay ke, he mahabaho, jo tumne kaha, so lana sach hai. Kya? Ye man ko nigrah mein lana. We'll be so happy. Close the Gita, let's party. Here in Arjun, he's saying, and then the Supreme Lord Krishna, he's agreeing to it. Come on. That's what I wanted. That's what is the truth. Yes, this mind, it has to just enjoy the way it wants. But then the next two lines, Krishna says, two things you have to do. Abhyasena kaunteya vairagyena cha grihyate. Two things, abhyasa and vairagya. And that's what Prabhupada has given. Just see how expertise of Prabhupada. Prabhupada gave these two things for us to control our mind and senses. The abhyas is chanting of the 16 rounds of Hare Krishna Mahamantra. That's the abhyasa. And the vairagya, the four regulative principles. Now, initially, when you listen that you have to chant Hare Krishna, you can begin with one round, two round. And then you go to your hostel in the morning when you are taking a cool shower. Agarbati jalake appears to be quite a peaceful act of just chanting two rounds. Yes, good feeling. I got a good feeling. But then, as you keep coming for the lectures, the preachers here, they tell you, by the way, there are the four regulative principles also. Only four. Oh, acha. What are they? No meat eating. Oh. No meat eating. Okay. Fish? Fish is okay, fish. For Bengalis, fish, they don't consider that as non-vegetarian. Especially, you know. For them, it's water cucumber. Jal ki kakdi. Eggs? You mean to say not even eggs? Come on. Eggs are so good for health. Huh? So good for health. Do you know what eggs were used for earlier? Before it was made into some edible stuff. Eggs, the yolk, the yellow part of the egg inside, it was used as adhesive. Jaise fevicol hota na, adhesive. It was used as adhesive. So what it does inside then? Imagine, fevicol ka omelette bana ke koi khilayega tumko. Pata nahi ban sakta hai kya wo. but it was used as an adhesive. In Bombay once, you know, one seminar I was giving on vegetarianism. So every different kinds of meat, and then finally it came to egg. So everyone was like, egg mein kya problem hai? What is omelette, you know, anda fry, omelette and all this, so tasty. So then I said, do you know actually what is it, what that yellow thing is? It's the menstrual fluid of chicken. Arivo. In case if you don't know what menstrual fluid is, better you know. In case if somebody is still having hopes that egg is something which is going to benefit. So, no meat eating. Of course, you know, after hearing all these horrific details about meat eating and eggs and menstrual fluid and, you know, all these red meat is full of chemicals, and sometimes you find fishes, there is human excreta inside the fish. Yeah, Bombay fish. Mumbai, the entire city where the excreta is dumped in the ocean. In case you don't know what excreta is, stool, sabka tatti. Ab samajh mein aaya? Wo sab samandar mein dalte hain. Usko kaun khata hai udhar? Machliyan khati. Wo machliyon ko phir kaun khata hai? Ye log hi khate hain. Usko jab kaatte hain kai baar, usme se nikal bhi aata hai. Haan, it's true. Now you, and then they say, eating brain food. We are eating brain food. Good for brain. So, you know, all these things, okay, meat eating. Then intoxication. No, you may say, oh, well, I'm not into, like, you know, hard drinks. I'm into soft drinks. I don't, you know, have, like, you know, rum or whiskey or theka, desi daru, theka sharab, not like that. But then no tea and coffee. Usne kya guna kiya hai? Kai baar aise, are chai coffee to sabse masoom drink hai. Beguna hai, beguna. Chai coffee ko kyon tum log kasauti pe rakh rahe ho? चलो ठीक है, चाय कॉफी, चलो आप भी क्या याद रखेंगे प्रभु जी, आपने बोला छोड़ दिया, चलो आगे बताओ. गैम्बलिंग, नो गैम्बलिंग. गैम्बलिंग आता भी नहीं है, दिमाग भी नहीं है, कोई कसिनो भी नहीं है, आता भी नहीं है. ज्यादा से ज्यादा लूडो खेला है. है ना? लेकिन फाइनल ब्रह्मास्त्र जब प्रीचर छोड़ता है, वो एकदम ऐसा जो बोलते हैं ना, ट्रेमर, अर्थक्वेक का रिक्टर स्केल पे 9.9. वो क्या है? नो इलिसिट सेक्स. सेक्स, सेक्स के आगे नो मत लगाने का कभी. देयर शुड नॉट बी एनी नो इन फ्रंट ऑफ दैट वेरी पॉपुलर वर्ड. No, whatever sex it is, whether it is licit or whether it is illicit, it's good. There is, you see, many times, you know, in India, people, they don't talk about it so much openly. You know? Coming from very traditional Hindu families, and you know, these things are not talked about. But then done a lot. नहीं तो ये आबादी कहां से है? ऊपर से कोई टपक रहे हैं क्या? नहीं नहीं, बात नहीं कर रहा है. no, no, we don't talk about that. You know. So, you know, very sophisticated words are used, you know, that we just went for honeymoon. Oh, just honeymoon. Huh? Or it's just Suhag Raat. Suhag Raat hai. Ghoongat utha raha hu main. Bas utna hi hota hai kya khali? To hum log sunte hain, gaate hain. Haan, Suhag Raat hai. Ghoongat, dulhan. Doodh ka glass. तो मेरा एक फ्रेंड था उसको फर्स्ट उसको बहुत टेंशन आ रहा था उसको टेंशन उसका फर्स्ट नाइट का टेंशन आ रहा था क्या फर्स्ट नाइट में क्या हो इतना सब कुछ उसने पूरा एक्साइटेड था इतने सालों से वेट कर रहा हूं इतना सुना है देखा है सो ही वाज लाइक रियली सो Till now, he was saying, I have been only a spectator. Ab akhade mein utarne wala hu. So finally, I'm going to jump into the arena of that must, the most awaited. So then, I still remember, you know, some of my friends who were like from Punjab and they were very outgoing. So he was like, you know, a sheepish guy, shy, coy, sheepish, like that. So he was asking one of my friends, you know, Harjinder, that, kya hota hai, matlab, how is it, like, you know, just kind of motivate me. So he's, you know, now motivating him. He said, see, first of all, when you enter inside, you know, when you enter after, you know, all the ceremonies and all the gifts taking and then thanking everyone is done, you know, so she'll be waiting, by the way. So she has to wait, and, you know, the whole typical Suhag Raat scene, you know. So you enter, then you know, kind of, you dim the lights. Light should be not totally switched off. It should be dim lights. And then there should be some very, you know, romantic music. Initially it should be romantic, but then it can be passionate to arouse the already aroused lust inside. Phir kya? Wahan par tu light ko dhima kar dena. Music thoda sa. हाँ उस टाइप का बजा देना फिर तू बाहर आ जा मैं संभाल लूंगा सो व्हेन बॉयज स्पेशली व्हेन दे हियर नो इलिसिट सेक्स which includes no net practice. We'll take time to decode that. Ek hota hai na, batting on the pitch, and ek hota hai net practice. So, four regulative principles. When Prabhupada went to America, there were already some Indians who were preaching some spirituality over there. There was one Mr. Mishra, Dr. Mishra, and he told Prabhupada, you are going to tell them about four regulative principles? Are you mad? To Americans? No meat eating? You know, they are like, they are born with sausages and, you know, steak and all that, you know. No meat eating, no illicit sex for Americans. They'll shoot you. So over there, now imagine Srila Prabhupada, he didn't compromise. He, from day one, he set the standards. No meat eating, no intoxication, no gambling. And that time in the 60s, the culture was hippie culture. Now hippie culture, what is hippie culture that time? Which means the kind of sex they would get indulge themselves in. The kind of intoxication they were having, even the other, you know, so-called pious Americans, they would like consider it as a taboo. And that was the audience sitting in Prabhupada, in front of Prabhupada. Drugged, stoned, you know, into all kinds of unmentionable, illicit, illegitimate sex. And there Srila Prabhupada is saying, no illicit sex, no intoxication. So it was not just this no which Prabhupada gave, because, you know, sometimes you will find people, you know, they don't like tea and coffee. Sometimes they are vegetarians because they can't stand meat for so many reasons. Like there was this one Bob Cohen, American, he was a vegetarian. He came to Prabhupada and he found out that these Hare Krishnas are vegetarian. So he thought that Prabhupada will be impressed. So he approached them. I am one American you must have met, I am a vegetarian. So Prabhupada said, so even monkeys are. Even monkeys are vegetarian. So just becoming a vegetarian, just following the four regulative principles, Prabhupada said, when one follows these four regulative principles, one becomes a human being. That's the beginning of human form of life. Then comes spirituality later on. So when Krishna said abhyasa and vairagya, that's what Prabhupada gave. Abhyas generally, you know, in Marathi also, abhyas generally, what do we understand abhyas? Kitab lo, abhyas kara. Abhyas karto hai, abhyas karaycha hai, abhyas, abhyas, abhyas. Now imagine now, if you take that meaning, if you have a book, your engineering book, uska abhyas kar rahe ho. And there is TV going on, and there is radio going on, and you know, somebody who is chatting loudly, gossiping, all these sounds all around you. Will you be able to focus properly in that abhyas? So even if your abhyas, you are having the right book in your hand, and you are having the right intention to focus on that. But if all these distractions all around will not help you focus, so why? The vairagya is equally important along with abhyasa, which means if you want to focus on your abhyasa, all these things should be shut off. Now, the other extreme is sometimes people, they shut off all these things and they shut off the book also. Matlab, TV band kiya, रेडियो बंद किया, इन सब का मुंह बंद किया, लाइट भी बंद कर दिया, और फिर आंखें भी बंद किया. नो, प्रैक्टिसिंग फोर रेगुलेटिव प्रिंसिपल्स, इफ इट इज लाइक शटिंग ऑफ ऑल दीज डिस्ट्रैक्शंस, देन यू हैव टू ओपन द बुक एंड डू द अभ्यास. सो बोथ दे हैव टू गो हैंड इन हैंड. दैट्स व्हाट कृष्णा इज सेइंग. If you want to advance, वो लंगर निकालना मतलब, अभी लंगर निकाल दिया लेकिन ये नहीं कर रहा है, रोइंग नहीं कर रहा है. और दूसरा एक्सट्रीम क्या था, हमने स्टोरी में सुना, के जा रहा है, के जा रहा है, लंगर ही नहीं निकाल रहा है, के जा रहा है. सो मेनी टाइम्स इन इंडिया स्पिरिचुअलिटी इज जाओ जाओ, ये व्रत, ये मंदिर, ये तप, ये तीर्थ स्थान, सब कुछ करते रहो, लंगर ही नहीं निकाला है. तो घूम फिर के फिर आ जाता क्या है, वापस से वही ईश्वरो हम अहम भोगी सिद्धो हम बलवान सुखी, दैट अटैचमेंट राउंड एंड राउंड. देयरफॉर It appears to be a lot of spiritual activities going on, but it's like running on a treadmill. भाग रहे, भाग रहे, भाग रहे. देखा कहाँ है? एक घंटे बाद उधर ही है. So you have to know the proper way. In the Chaitanya Charitamrita that is mentioned, just like someone who is swimming. So the act of swimming is, you have your one hand ahead and then the other one ahead, and you keep pedaling your feet. And the proper act of swimming, when you do, what will happen? You will see you are inching ahead in water. You are moving ahead in the water. Now, someone who is swimming, he moved one foot ahead and then he asks, abhi kya karu? तो जो कोच है वो क्या बोलेगा? वही करो जो पहले स्टेप में किया, जो एक फुट आगे तुमको लाया, वही करो. अच्छा ठीक है, उसने वही किया, अब क्या करो? अरे वही करते रहो. फॉर अ स्विमर यू हैव टू कीप डूइंग द सेम थिंग अगेन एंड अगेन. एंड समटाइम्स वी सी दोज हु डोंट नो द प्रॉपर वे ऑफ फ्लैपिंग हैंड्स एंड लेग्स. नया आदमी, उसको स्विमिंग बिल्कुल नहीं आता है, उसको ढकेल दिया पानी के अंदर, कितना हाथ पैर मारता है ना. नए नए स्विमिंग करने, आप लोग कौन स्विमिंग सीख रहे हैं, या कितने लोगों को आता है स्विमिंग? तो जिनको नहीं आता है वो लोग, आप लोग उतरे तो होंगे ना कभी, है ना, कि खाली बाल्टी मग्गा लेके जाते हैं. तो आप लोग कभी उतरे होंगे स्विमिंग सीखने के लिए. देखो जो नया नया तैराक अभी भी सीखने जा रहा है, कितना हाथ पैर मारता है, ऐसे लगता है कि पूरा वो स्विमिंग पूल का पानी बाहर वो निकाल देगा. सो ही फ्लैप्स हिज हैंड्स एंड लेग्स सो विग्रेसली एंड ही थिंक्स, मैं तो क्रॉस कर दिया हो गया अभी तक. After 5 minutes of flapping, इधर ही, अभी तक इधर ही है, एक फुट भी आगे नहीं गया, इतना पानी उछाल दिया, इतना आवाज किया. And sometimes you will find expert swimmers, they will swim as if like butter, as if you know, like hot knife going into butter. Have you experienced? Soft butter के अंदर hot knife कैसे जाता है? Like that, you know, मक्खन की तरह swimming होता है. पता ही नहीं चलता है गया कहां, आएगा कि नहीं आएगा. सो व्हाट वी हैव बीन टॉट इन दिस प्रोसेस ऑफ कृष्ण कॉन्शियसनेस इज दैट बैलेंस, बैलेंस द अभ्यास एंड द वैराग्य. एंड दिस लॉजिक इज एप्लीकेबल not just for achieving Krishna prem. This logic is applicable even if you want to achieve anything material for your studies. Two simple principles. Yesterday somebody was asking me, concentration nahi ho raha hai, book samne hai, pata nahi kuch kisi aur ka chehra dikhta hai kitab ke andar, kuch bhi nahi dikhta hai, sab dikhta hai, kuch likha hi nahi kitab ke andar, blank dikh raha hai sab kuch, kuch samajh mein nahi aata. So with the abhyasa, there has to be vairagya. What is vairagya? Vairagya is your lifestyle. So unless you have a lifestyle which is oriented towards that abhyasa will have no meaning. Okay? And simply vairagya without abhyasa, it's just, you know, you have so many animals who are quite renounced and bairagi. They look like they are quite renounced and bairagi. Like a lion, I am told that a lion, he engages in sexual act only once a year. Appears to be quite self-controlled. But that doesn't make him a tapasvi or a yogi or a spiritualist. So herein, just like if you have seen, when a rocket is launched, Have you seen? When a rocket is launched, there are various sections of the rocket or satellite. Let's give the example of a satellite. When a satellite is launched, so there are all these sections which thrust the satellite to go up into space, and they keep releasing itself from the main satellite. So there are these detachable parts which is used only to launch the satellite in the space, and those detachable parts, they detach and they keep unloading itself. That's the word. They keep unloading and detaching itself. So similarly, when you want your spiritual rocket to be launched in this outer space, all these unnecessary attachments you have to keep detaching yourself from. And the more lighter then you become, the higher up you'll go. And that's for just our peace of mind also. The less you carry on this journey of your life, just like, you know, travel light. That's what they advertise. When you are traveling, travel light. When you are traveling light, you'll experience the bliss of the journey. What to speak of the destination? And Krishna is saying that the destination is having everything for you, more than what your so-called house in this material world can give you. So why you have to carry all of that? So similarly, when we are talking of progressing and advancing in our spiritual life, we have to understand what is the right way, what is the right mood. Just knowing the mood and not the right way again will not suffice. You have to know the right mood in which the process has to be followed, and then the right way the process has to be performed. And this combination, that is what Krishna is saying, is real renunciation. Thank you all very much. Hare Krishna. Does spiritual progress and material progress go ill together? Abraham Lincoln, he once made a very nice statement. He said that if somebody asks me to cut a tree and has given me 6 hours, 5 hours I will use to sharpen the axe and 1 hour to cut the tree. So what is that sharpening of the axe? That's spirituality. And then even just 1 hour of using that axe, you will be using that axe with the best quality of the axe. For an artist, if the pencil goes blunt, then yes, he can sit with the pencil and the paper and try to sketch something for hours, but everything will appear distorted and blunt. But then he stops sketching, takes a sharpener, starts sharpening the pencil. So in one sense, that sharpening of the pencil is very much contributing to the quality of the sketch which is about to come now. So that sharpening of the pencil or sharpening of the axe, if that is considered to be the chanting or the spiritual practice, apart from giving us Krishna Prem, it will also sharpen your intelligence to give a quality of yourself to the sections of society you are associated with. If you are a son, you will give the quality service as a son to your parents. If you are a brother to someone, if you are a, you know, a friend to someone, if you are a student to someone, later on if you become, you know, a teacher to someone, everything, whatever you do, it will be done with that quality. So yes, forget about they being ill together, they complement each other. And it will help one to grow. Then everything becomes spiritual. Once the pencil and the axe is sharpened to that degree, to that sharpness, then whatever you know, that person does with that sharpened intelligence and mind and senses, it's done for the benefit of everyone. When it is done for the benefit of everyone, then there is nothing material to that. Yeah? देखो, सबसे पहले आपको ये निर्धारित करना है कि आपके जीवन में सबसे महत्वपूर्ण क्या है इस समय, सबसे महत्वपूर्ण क्या है। यदि आपके जीवन में इस समय सबसे महत्वपूर्ण आपकी भक्ति है, भागवत का अध्ययन है, तो ये सारी चीजें अनावश्यक हो जाती हैं। जैसे कि एक उदाहरण मैं आपको दूं कि किसी ने आपको 100-100 की गड्डी दी, 2000 रुपए 100 की गड्डी, 2000 रुपए गिनने के लिए। जब आप गिन रहे हो और उस समय कोई फोन बजता है, कोई रेडियो में गाना बज रहा है, कोई आपको पूछ रहा है चाय पियेंगे क्या, हाँ मार्केट का ये वो जो भी आप बोल रहे हैं, हाँ ये सब जब आप गिन रहे हैं, तो उस समय आपका रिस्पांस क्या रहेगा बताओ? वो नोट गिनते समय आपका रिस्पांस क्या रहेगा?
नोट ही गिनना चाहिए,
हाँ है ना। उस समय चाहे नरेंद्र मोदी जी का फोन आ जाए, खैर वो थोड़ा एक्सट्रीम हो गया, आपको फिर टेंशन आएगा ये नोट सही है कि नहीं है, फिर जो उनका फोन इस टाइम आ रहा है कुछ नई चीज तो नहीं आ गई। तो जैसे नोट गिनते समय आप अपना पूरा ध्यान, पूरा केंद्र उस पे लगा देते हो, और चाहे कोई भी आपसे बात करने आए, उस समय आप अपने आप को विक्षेपित नहीं होने देते हो, तो ये भागवत का अध्ययन और भगवान का हरिनाम उस तरीके से लेना है। तो इसको अगर आप इतना महत्वपूर्ण अभी समय मान रहे हो, तो हां बाकी सारी चीजें फिर अनावश्यक हो जाती। हरि बोल।